Finance Minister Mondli Gungubele took to the stand at the PIC Commission of Inquiry and told the commission that his appointment to chair the board of the PIC was dramatic in June of last year. He says his first meeting was about finding out why the board of the fund manager had handled the allegations of impropriety against then CEO Dan Matjila the way it did. Matjila was facing allegations of having facilitated funding for a company belonging to a woman said to be his girlfriend. Gungubele says there were clear divisions on the board as there were always some board members who were pro-Matjila. He did not want to give their names to the commission. After Matjila wrote a letter of intention to leave the PIC, the board decided it would be best if he left with immediate effect. The board was divided on the appointment of the acting CEO in CFO Matepo Mori. Gungubele had to take the final decision. He says the decision to find a permanent CEO has been put on ice until the commission has finished its work and they can decide on the caliber of a person that should be appointed. Gungubele says while the Minister of Finance did not force the board to resign, he did ask whether, given the negativity around the organization, they still think they should continue their work at PIC.
We sat as a board and had a discussion. I do want to put it up front. One of the issues, remember, I have this challenge of acting as a chair, sometimes acting as a minister. The minister's view was, if you know him, he's an upright chap. Said, do you think you guys still make sense? And so on. Have you ever discussed that? And at that point, I asked the board to look at this thing on the 1st of February. And the board was seized with the matter. And the board analyzed the entire situation. And looked at the email from unknown source after email and a lot of other allegations. And the board said, we're in a situation where the decisions we take, the quality will be questioned. Is it not the right thing to, whilst we are clear with our conscience, this is not acceptance of any guilt, but for public perception point of view and the size of the asset, whose decision, our decision have got implications for, is it not prudent to just stay aside? But we said we are clear that this is not an indication of acceptance of any guilt. It is at that instance that the board thought, let us resign.